هيا على الفلاح.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، والعاقبة للمتقين، ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله، صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. My beloved brothers and sisters, I remind you about the consciousness of Allah, something called taqwa, taqwa Allah. Be conscious of Allah. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala constantly to help you to develop your taqwa. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant it to you. And make an effort to develop your relationship with Allah by using the energy that He has given you to do the right thing and not the wrong thing. This energy that I have derived, remember my brothers and sisters, I got it from Allah. And remember, Allah expects me to use it to do that which pleases Him. So if I were to use my energies in the displeasure of Allah, I will be the one who will lose. Many people unfortunately forget that they have to return to Allah. They forget that they will have to present their book to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What book is this? It is the book of your deeds, my brothers, my sisters. The deeds that you do, they are written. Whatever you say, whatever you do is written. Be mindful of that. My brothers and sisters, sometimes people are addicted to bad things. Sometimes people are addicted to intoxicants. People are addicted to sinful behavior. Remember, you need to seek the help of Allah. You need to change yourself. Those who are addicted, for example, to pornography, my brothers and sisters, you can do better. Remember, you have to answer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. These addictions are not healthy for you. And you know what? Spiritually, they're damaging. Just like the addiction to alcohol, just like the addiction to drugs, or just like the addiction to something bad and evil. Subhanallah, these addictions are terrible. My brothers and sisters, make sure that you seek the help of Allah. One of the primary things that we are taught is to improve the companionship we have. The company you have makes you or breaks you. If you're not going to improve in that company, it will drag you down right to the ground, and it will take you even further down until you have suffered such a great loss that it becomes difficult to find yourself again. When Allah asks you to be disciplined, and when Allah asks you to set yourself rules and regulations that are conforming to what Allah has set down, He does it for your own benefit, subhanallah. So remember, Allah wants you to do better than you are doing. You must make sure you have better company. The people you have as friends need to be brilliant people. Don't have thieves as your friends. Don't have those who deceive, those who are vulgar, those who swear. Don't have those who abuse others, those who are criminals. Don't have them as your friends, my brothers and sisters. Whatever your friends are doing, if you consider them your friends, it is just a matter of time before you start engaging in that. And you know what? You may never come out of that, while they may one day come out of it. My brothers and sisters, this is a serious problem that we have. People become irresponsible. They stop thinking about the future. They don't realize sometimes when you're young, you fall into the wrong company. Get out of it as soon as you can. Get out of it as soon as you can. Sometimes shifting where you live might also be a good solution. Dear parents who have children who are struggling with addictions, remember, sometimes if you shift location completely and go into a totally different environment, perhaps you may help your child. And this is why we are taught in the Arabic language, al-jaru qabla ad-dar, which means when you're looking for a house, before the house, what is of greater importance is your neighbors. Who are your neighbors? What type of a neighborhood do you live in? Try to do better, or protect yourself as best as you can. Mix with the right people. Then, my brothers and sisters, some of these addictions happen to be online. People are addicted to games, subhanallah. People are addicted to bad games sometimes. And when I say bad games, have you noticed how many of these games give you points when you break the law, when you harm people, when you kill people? Astaghfirullah. Now there are games that give you points when you rape people. There are games that give you points when you abuse others. What type of games are these? Can we not hold someone responsible? My brothers and sisters, I don't think it's going to be so easy to stop these games from being made, because someone somewhere has an agenda. You gain points for immoral behavior. You gain points for nudity. You gain points for pedophilia. Imagine on games. Astaghfirullah. May Allah safeguard our children. May Allah safeguard us. This is happening on the globe. And you know what? Sometimes young children are exposed to this in a very dangerous and damaging way. So be careful, be responsible, communicate well with your family members, siblings, your children, your brothers and sisters, subhanallah, your parents. Communicate well, befriend them, spend a lot of time with your children. COVID-19 has given us an opportunity to spend time with our loved ones. My brothers, my sisters, remember, when you spend time with your loved ones, you talk to them, you eat with them, you pray with them, you've actually protected them, because they won't have all that time to do whatever is negative. And if you were to play a game, number one, don't get addicted. Number two, make sure the games you're playing are filled with high morals and values. Never score points by doing something immoral, sinful, unacceptable, or criminal, even if it is just a game. Islam prohibits it. Imagine, Islam prohibits even a game where you've got to kill people and get points. Islam prohibits even a game where you have to engage in criminal activity or break the law in order to earn points. Remember that. Even if the world allows it, you're a Muslim. You're cleaner than that. You're supposed to be filled with the highest level of morals and values. Don't allow yourself to be degraded by anonymous people who have created these platforms without, subhanallah, any morals or values. They've either intended to drop you and you're being dropped. They've intended to target you and you're allowing yourself to be targeted. And willfully, people pay to participate, subhanallah. Be careful, my brothers and sisters. These addictions are absolutely dangerous. Not just addictions, even a little of these immoral games is not acceptable in the eyes of Allah. Try to do that which is moral, which is upright. Those of you who are into IT and those who are perhaps creating games from amongst us, let's create the best of games. Why can't we gain points to do a good deed, to feed the poor, to reach out to those who are perhaps drowning, to save lives, perhaps to do Hajj, perhaps to give zakah? Why can't we create those games, my brothers and sisters, and make them beautiful games? We will get a lot of people to promote these games, subhanallah. Then we can give prizes to those who have done good deeds, engaging in the pillars of Islam, engaging in high, meaning practices of high morals and values, subhanallah. Looking out for the elderly. Imagine gaining points for helping someone cross the road, gaining points for looking for orphans and meeting their needs, looking for widows and taking care of them, fi sabilillah. If these are our games, we will definitely have a better future with better generations. But today, the swear words, the type of words that are used, the F word is being used by children, little children who are actually capturing it on videos and posting those videos on social media. With the F word and the B word and the P word and the D word and all these words that are created, subhanallah, they were not even in our dictionary when we were young. But look at what's happening. Surely we should be conscious of this. It cannot be acceptable for me or for you to write such words in a book that we're going to be presenting on the Day of Judgment as a book of our deeds. And it's going to go to Allah, your Maker. And that book is filled with immoral behavior, bad words, the worst of words, immoral dress or whatever it may be. May Allah protect us. We have to be people who are very responsible. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us from this. So my brothers and sisters, another way of protecting yourself from the addictions online is to do whatever you're doing in full view of the members of your family. Subhanallah. So be it your phone or your tablet or your laptop, sit in a public place. Allow people to share with you whatever you're doing or share it with them. Subhanallah. May Allah grant us ease. Many of you might be thinking, I'm not going to do that. But if you have a problem, identify it. Seek help and you will be helped. There are so many people who are doing a lot of good work remedying those who have addictions of this nature. My brothers and sisters, take it seriously. Admit that you need help. Be strong and work towards it. Fight your nafs. Fight the bad side of yourself. And remember, if you were to be transparent, you would actually be able to come out of the suffering that you're in. It doesn't bring about any goodness. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us and our offspring, our boys and girls, our children, and the children of humanity at large. For indeed, we are part of a larger family. We need to be concerned about everyone. There are some who are out to reduce you to a person who has no values, no morals. You're a Muslim. You're a believer. You can do better than that. You are answerable to Allah, not to me. I'm just encouraging you to do the right thing. That's it. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is definitely the most forgiving, the most merciful. He's waiting for you to improve yourself. He's waiting for you to actually improve yourself, my brothers, my sisters. So remember, if you have good company, and if you seek help, and if you are in a public place, meaning public as in the common room in your house or a common place in your house where others can watch what you're doing, inshallah, you will be helped in a good way. Then fulfill your obligations unto Allah. Keep yourself occupied with good things, and inshallah, you won't be occupied with that which is bad. If you fulfill your 5 daily prayers, you make wudu, you wash yourself, and you fulfill your prayers for the love you have for Allah, you will automatically be helped when it comes to eradicating bad things. You will do it less. You won't have the time for it. And then community activities, very good. Go out and help people. Reach out to people. Talk to your siblings. Talk to your grandparents. Talk to anyone, your parents, your own parents. Make sure that you've reached out to people. Don't be lazy. Occupy yourself with good things so that shaitan does not occupy you with bad things. Remember that. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant every one of us ease and make us more conscious of what we're doing. So my brothers and sisters, then again, we need to know when Allah has blessed us with an eyesight, with good health, with wealth, all of these, we need to use them in the right direction. All of these, we need to make sure that we actually use them so well that the day they are taken away from us, and they probably will at some stage, we would not regret the way we used them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us more conscious of our relationship with Him. I thought perhaps it would be interesting to mention some of the addictions and some of the remedies that we have. Seek the forgiveness of Allah. Turn to Allah. Allah loves you. It's about time we changed our ways and habits. Trust me, we don't know who's going to live and for how long we're going to live. We don't want to die with the wrong thing in our hands, having done the wrong thing. That is why we have these blessed, beautiful reminders to remind us to say, do the right thing in your life. You don't want to regret when you go to meet with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or even in your grave, when the first few questions you're going to be asked, one of them is about your prayer. Did you pray? Inshallah, we can do better. Those of you who are weak, perhaps you're praying 4 times a day, you can up your game to 5. You can. You will, by the help of Allah. If you're determined, you will. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala strengthen you. Those of you who are struggling to dress in the most appropriate way, you know what? With the help of Allah and your determination, inshallah, you will get there. And when you are doing the right thing, don't ever take a step backwards. Don't, my brothers and sisters, if you have taken a step backwards, come back. Allah is waiting for you. Allah wants you. Allah will be so happy the day you come back to Him. In this obedience, my brothers and sisters, I repeat, if you've taken a step back, come back. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide myself and all of us and give us the loftiest ranks of paradise, forgiving us for our shortcomings. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the best of this world and the next. أقول قولي هذا وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Thank you so much for listening to this short message. I pray that it has increased you in a little bit of motivation and hope, and the same applies to all of us. جزاكم الله خير. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.